Sometimes when you're using Final Cut Pro X, you want to add a filter to a whole bunch of clips. So for example, you might have all these clips and you've done your edit and you want to create some sort of different look, say a black and white look or an aged film look. You want to drag a filter, for example, like aged film here, over onto a clip, but you may want to apply that filter especially after you've adjusted the parameters of the filter, you may want to apply it to all the clips so that you get one sort of consistent look. Now in FCPx, you basically have to drag it to every single clip. So you can't easily apply one filter to many clips. You can't even sort of highlight all the clips and then drag that filter across. It only basically gets applied to whichever clip you drop it into, like so. So an easy way to do this or to achieve this is to create what we call an adjustment layer. So we can apply a filter to one layer that then applies that filter to all the layers below it. And we're going to create an adjustment layer so that we can save it later in FCPx and use it for all our projects. So we can quickly apply filters to bunches of clips. First, open up Motion, and let's create a new project. And this time it's Final Cut Title. Now, just open that. Now, all we have to do here is delete the text, as you can see. Now, just go to Save As, and save that as an adjustment layer. And we'll put it in the category of, let's put it into a new category called adjustment. We'll create that and we'll publish it. Okay, now that it's published, just go back to Final Cut and you will find it actually under the titles. So let's go to titles, go to adjustment, and there we have it, an adjustment layer. Now the adjustment layer actually just is like a title. It sits on top of all these other layers. So let's just drag it over here. At the moment, it basically is nothing on top of these layers. It's basically going to work as a holder for any filters that we put into it. So let's go back to our filters. Here we are, filters. And let's say we wanna drop the aged film filter in there. Let's drop it onto that layer. And there you go, you can see it's been applied to all the layers below it. And so whatever you do to this aged film filter, say we change the grain to realistic grain. Let's say we add something else. Let's say aged paper to make it a little bit more obvious. There we go. There we go, now very obvious. So we've got both aged film and aged paper added to all the layers below that adjustment layer. This is a very handy way to create one unified or consistent look across all your clips. And once you've created it, it's always going to be there, so you can add it to any of your films or projects as you like. Of course, you can copy and paste that as well to add it to different parts of your sequence. There you go, I'll put the download link in the notes in case you don't want to go through that simple process and you just want to download it for free.
Monkey see, monkey like, monkey do. Banana Mama TV.